Now, what happened for Muslim League? What happened for Congress? Did Congress and Muslim League go hand in hand? And how did the Muslim League emerge as the strongest conference or the solo spokesman of the Muslims? Let us discuss this for a while. See here. So the Muslim League and Congress, how did the power, the transfer of power got transformed here? See here, in 1945, the Britain has decided to set up a central executive council of truly Indians, where it is an initial work or a temporary preliminary work to establish the independence of India. So the Muslim League decided that they want to have their own members and they would be electing their Muslim representatives. When the elections were held in 1946, in the central level, the most of the Muslim seats are reserved for Muslims. The Muslim League has won 30, almost all the reserved seats at the central level, as well as coming to the provincial level, at the state levels, out of 509 seats, 442 seats were won by the Muslim League, which clearly shows that 86%, the clear percentage of the Muslim votes, that is 86% of the Muslim votes are in favor of the Muslim League. And at the same time, the non-Muslim votes towards the Congress has got 91% of the non-Muslim votes. It's clearly evident that Muslims started to consider its representation with the Muslim League, and the others, especially the Hindus, got associated with the Congress. Now, the Congress got 91% of the non-Muslim vote, means the Hindu vote. The Muslim League got 86%, which means it's clearly saying that the Muslim League is the only and only spokesman of Muslims. The entire interests of the Muslims would be addressed very clearly, perfectly by the Muslim League. This was the intention expressed by the voting procedure, what has happened for us. So now what happened after this is the next? How would the states be created? What was the next possible alternative? Next, what are the steps taken by the Congress or the Muslim League to come forward or to move ahead forward? Let us see them. 1946, March. The Britain decided to send a cabinet committee to come to India, especially the capital region of Delhi, to address the issue of whether India should be united or to be partitioned. What are the basis for that? What would be the all-party approach? All these things. The cabinet toured for nearly 3 months, concluded very clearly, and came with the conclusion that it should have a three-tier confederation, three-level confederation, and provided India will be united. This was an initial agreement which was made by all parties, and all parties like Indian National Congress, Muslim League, all of them have accepted this point and made the agreement with them. But as the agreement was short-lived, the Muslim Leagues came forward with an intention that the ideas, the views of the people of the Muslims are not at all addressed properly. And the point is that the people will not feel secured in a nation where majority of them are Hindus. And they came with a point that we are going to go for a plan of direct action. So the direct action means that the people will come onto the roads. The people will come and do the work on the roads. People will be standing on the roads in order to express their view that they are going to do this. So finally, in August, they came to the plan of Direct Action Day. They asked all the Muslims to come onto the roads and to express their dissatisfaction against the three-tier confederation, which was made by the cabinet mission. So this dissatisfaction was started initially in August 1946. Many millions of people came onto the roads and the violence started in almost all the places, and it was done for many several days in Kolkata and all the other regions. Now, as the dissatisfaction started to grow and the disturbances created in the entire nation, by March 1946 to this August 1946, and as we move on to March 1947, the dissatisfaction was in a very high level. The Congress High Command had initially had very serious meetings with them, like whether to move forward on this or not. So they came up with an opinion that The Punjab. Should be divided into two parts, one for the Muslims, the other for the Hindus. The same with the case of the Bengal. One part for Hindus and the other part for the Muslims. Now, once the Congress High Command has come with an opinion that they are going to do this because the violence is very high, the people are lost at a very high, large in numbers. In order to stop the violence and the communal issues, the Congress immediately has to take some action on this. And at the same time, Mr. Wavell, the Viceroy of India, has been replaced by Mr. Mountbatten, the last Viceroy of India in that period of 1947. So they came forward, like Wavell will be replaced by Mountbatten. And Mountbatten had a last final round of talks with the Indian leaders as well as with the Muslim League leaders, asking that what is the stage or step to be moved forward to stop the communal riots. So he finally concluded that India should be given freedom only and only on the basis that India is going to be divided. So the regions of northwestern regions of India, the Punjab belt, and then the Sindh region, the Balochistan part, the Afghanistan part of small region, and the Bengal part is going to be added for the new creation state, and the state will be created and the transfer of power will be done from British domain to the new state, that is on 14th of August 1947. And in this way, the new state of Pakistan has been created. And on 15th of August 1947, we got our Indian independence. The independence was a happy point to be there, but at the same time, the division was done on the communal basis, on the religious basis, where many of the people have lost their own things. Hindus and Muslims started to fight with each other, and the people lost, many of them lost their lives, their properties, their lands, and their buildings and everything. So let us see what happened next. How was the solution come out? What was Mahatma Gandhi doing at that point of time? Is really Mahatma Gandhi happy with this division? What step did he do to solve this one? Did he have any point to make it, or is he satisfied with the decision? What did Jawaharlal Nehru point out this point? Let us see this. What are the consequences which were felt after the partition of India and Pakistan?